Hey there, and welcome to my new tutorial. It has been a while, but since there is a new preview version of Unreal Engine 5.5, I wanted to take a closer look and test the new Megalights, an Unreal Engine feature that has been introduced as an experimental version in this preview. So in my opinion, it can be a real game changer for the Unreal Engine and architectural visualization. So it's worth taking a look. So I made this interior scene for the purpose of this tutorial, and I've also done some cinematic versions of it that you can see at the beginning of the tutorial. And if you are interested, I could post scene one on my Patreon page, so you can take a look. Write me down in the comments. To begin with, we can check how everything looks. So it's basically kitchen, living room, and workspace. So we can have a look right now at the FPS counter that currently sits around 17 or 20 FPS, but I'm working on a laptop at this moment, and it's 3080 GPU, and with a 4K resolution display, and also running the recording screen and all that stuff in the background. So, but it's pretty good to work on, and we could put down the resolution a little bit, but it's okay this way because of this new function. So what it is actually, let's go into the project settings, and when we type Megalight, we will see that there is an option to turn it on. So it wasn't there before. It's introduced, as I said, in this new version. And the only thing left for us to do is to go to the post-process volume, search for Megalights, and also right there you have the option to turn on or off the Megalights. So I will, before we go on and off with this, I will just show you how this scene is set up. So as you can see, we have a lot of lights, as you might have as well in interior scenes like this, because we need to have a lot of these spotlights and also a lot of LED lights that will affect our scene. So before there was a struggle with performance in it, but right now, as you can see, it's hitting around 20 frames per second. And when we turn off the Megalights, the FPS drops significantly. So you can see it's 8 frames per second, and it's really hard to work like this and to work with the scene. So the best thing is that basically all you have to do is to click on this little checkbox and then instantly gain around 50 milliseconds of performance. So now you can put a lot of lights in there, and it will increase your performance as you turn on Megalights. You can see also that it's affecting our scene a lot, and one great thing that I have noticed, it gets rid of this ugly nanite issue. So once Megalights are turned on, the issue is not there anymore, so we don't have to do the workarounds. Also, one nice thing is that you can see now the whole area, every light is here, and the shadows get a little bit softer. I've noticed some downsides as well, so if you have really thin shadows, it might not appear, but I think what we are gaining from it is really, really good. And since it's still an experimental feature, we can only expect it to improve more in the following months and years. So just the performance and the night issues solved are good enough. And with the performance, another thing that we could change a little bit is if we, for example, catch all the spotlights here, and we have one just about the statues, so we can get a closer look at it. And you can individually turn on and off Megalights for each light, so keep that in mind. So if you have an issue with the shadow for some lights, you can just go ahead and in that exact light turn it off. There is also the option, can make them ray traced or virtual shadow maps. So ray tracing is giving us a little bit harsher edges and some shapes that are not really nice, and at the cost, I think, a little bit more off of the performance, like a few milliseconds, we can have even better shadows here. So let's go ahead and you can demonstrate it on the whole scene. It's not that big of a difference if we change it, so I'll go ahead and play with it. And I think it's a great addition to the architectural visualization workflow if you have a lot of lights in our interior and exterior. So that's all for this short tutorial, and until the next time, take care and see you soon in the next one.